I'm here with Dr. Hannah Bentham, my friend and seismologist from the University of Leeds, where I'm visiting in Leeds, Yorkshire, UK. And we were just discussing the latest disaster to hit Nepal, the biggest aftershock in over hundreds that have hit since the main quake. So let's start there, Hannah. 7.3, the 7.8 is 6 times stronger, but this, of course, still devastating. Is it still considered an aftershock?
Well, it's the definition of an aftershock is a bit hazy, but because this latest earthquake is close in proximity to the main shock, so very close to location and in time, it is considered an aftershock, especially since it may have triggered, the main shock may have triggered this earthquake.
Right.
But the definition is a bit hazy, so for now, an aftershock until that is amended.
Fair enough. And it sounds like the new epicenter is about 150 kilometers east of the main quake, which puts it just outside of the rupture zone, or that area in the earth that slipped during that main quake. So again, just on the edge and just to the east. But this is an unusually large aftershock. Do we have any idea that we could see one this big?
So it was thought that an aftershock between 7 and 7.8 magnitude, and there will be a 1 in 200 chance of that occurring. So obviously very slim chances, but it has actually occurred.
Right.
But there was a chance.
Wow. Now, what are the chances moving forward? Will we get a whole new sequence of aftershocks after this one?
So aftershocks will be going on for days. Already half an hour after the 7.3 this morning, we had a 6.3. So there will be some around the magnitude 6 strength. So how long that sequence will go on for is unknown. So everybody's obviously watching the space and keeping their eyes out for any larger earthquakes.
Exactly, as shaking continues on the ground.
Yes, exactly. Nepal will still be shaking for days to come.
Wow. Now, after the initial earthquake, there was so much analysis done from seismologists around the world on what exactly happened. Now, I know it's so recent, but have we learned anything new from this new large aftershock? Any new revelations?
So not at the minute. It's a bit early, but the scientists at Leeds are kind of working around the clock to try and get some sort of new models out there to see the changes in the surface, what sort of uplift versus subsidence, to see if we can learn more about the earthquake itself.
Right, and University of Leeds is world renowned for their research in modelling tectonic active zones, right?
Correct. There's a NERC centre for observation and modelling called COMET, and that is based at Leeds, and a lot of the scientists will be, as I say, working sort of very hard.
Yeah, absolutely. And I know one of the sort of topics of discussion that has come up is it's interesting that this large aftershock happened to the east of the main quake, and there was some thought that maybe stress transference was happening to the west. So I know one of the things that the teams are working on is where the risks are now.
Yeah, that's great. So they are trying to look at, so as I say, the stress transfer to see maybe what might happen next. But as I say, it's very early days, so they will be updating these models in due course.
That's great. Thanks, Hannah.
You're welcome.